Scientists have been uncovering exoplanets with potential for habitability for years, with hundreds of millions already identified and new discoveries made daily. Yet, there isn't a planet quite like ours anywhere else in the universe that we know of. Recently, however, researchers have proposed that a number of exoplanets might even be more habitable than Earth. But do these worlds truly exist? And if so, does this mean there is life outside of our little world? An exoplanet, or extrasolar planet, is any planet that orbits a star outside our solar system. These planets vary greatly in size, from gas giants larger than Jupiter to small, rocky worlds like Mars and Earth. Most known exoplanets are located within a specific region of the Milky Way galaxy. Thanks to missions like NASA's Kepler space telescope, we've learned that planets may outnumber stars in our galaxy. The first exoplanets were identified in the 1990s, and since then, thousands have been discovered using various methods. Detecting these distant worlds is challenging. It's estimated that there could be at least 300 million potentially habitable exoplanets in the Milky Way alone. The Kepler mission, which concluded in 2018 after 9 years of hunting planets, identified many of these exoplanets and suggested that these rocky planets might support liquid water on their surfaces, a key ingredient for life as we know it. Though there are between 100 and 400 billion stars in the Milky Way, each potentially hosting at least one planet, the true number of planets could run into the trillions. Discovering exoplanets isn't as straightforward as one might think. Direct imaging, or seeing an exoplanet directly like we see Saturn from Earth, is rare. Most exoplanets are detected through the transit method, which observes the dimming of a star as a planet crosses in front of it. Other methods include analyzing the light spectrum of a star for signs of gravitational tugs from orbiting planets, which cause shifts in the star's light, and detecting them through gravitational lensing. By combining these techniques, astronomers are finding more exoplanets every day across the vast universe. To search for potentially life-supporting exoplanets, the focus often turns to planets within their star's habitable zone, also known as the Goldilocks zone, where conditions are neither too hot nor too cold for liquid water. However, for a planet to truly be considered habitable, it must also be the right size, and its host star must be stable. Our Sun, a yellow dwarf, has been stable for over 4.5 billion years, offering an ideal environment for life to thrive, a rarity not always mirrored by other stars in different systems. First detected by the HARPS telescope in 2016, Proxima B is the closest alien exoplanet to our solar system, located just 4.2 light-years away. Orbiting within the habitable zone of its host star, the red dwarf Proxima Centauri, Proxima B was initially thought to be at least 1.3 times the mass of Earth. However, recent observations by the new ESPRESSO telescope suggest it's only 17% more massive than our planet, making it more Earth-like than previously believed, and a prime candidate for hosting life due to its potential for liquid water. Yet, Proxima B's prospects dimmed the same year it was celebrated. A massive solar flare erupted from Proxima Centauri, 1,000 times brighter than the star itself, bombarding Proxima B with 4,000 times the level of ultraviolet radiation Earth would receive from a similar solar event from our Sun. This intense radiation could have sterilized the planet, obliterating any nascent life forms struggling to survive in such volatile conditions. But Proxima B is not the only contender in the quest for habitable worlds. Scientists have identified 24 superhabitable planets, and exomoons that might even surpass Earth in terms of fostering life. This concept of superhabitability was introduced in 2014 by researchers Rene Heller and John Armstrong, who argued that simply residing in a habitable zone isn't enough. For a planet to truly be suited for life, it might need to be older, larger, warmer, wetter, and possess higher levels of oxygen, alongside a longer-lasting host star. Heller and Armstrong proposed that the optimal mass for a super-Earth to support long-term habitability is about 2 Earth masses. This larger size would not only ensure radioactive decay in the planet's interior provides heat for a longer period, but would also mean stronger gravity to retain its atmosphere more effectively. These 24 superhabitable candidates orbit stars that meet the ideal criteria in terms of size, lifespan, and position within the habitable zone. Many orbit G-dwarf stars, similar to our Sun, but some circle K-dwarf stars, or orange dwarfs. These stars are cooler, less massive, and less luminous than our Sun, and more abundant in the Milky Way. Despite their subdued nature, these orange dwarfs offer a significant advantage. They can have lifespans ranging from 17 to 70 billion years, far exceeding the 10 billion year lifespan of our Sun. If life were to emerge on a planet orbiting a K-dwarf star, it would have substantially more time to evolve compared to Earth. Considering that on our planet, it took 3.5 billion years for complex life to develop, and another 500 million for advanced life forms like humans, life on a planet orbiting a K-dwarf could progress much further, potentially leading to even more sophisticated and diverse biological landscapes. Moreover, these superhabitable worlds, with their greater mass and higher gravity, could support thicker atmospheres, creating ideal conditions for airborne organisms to thrive and spread life across more extensive landmasses and habitats. Planetary scientists have pinpointed the optimal age for a superhabitable exoplanet to be around 5 to 8 billion years. These prime candidates for hosting life must have abundant water, as life as we know it cannot thrive without it. Additionally, planets with climates about 8 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than Earth, featuring more moisture, could potentially be more conducive to life. This is because generally, a warmer and wetter climate supports a richer diversity of life forms. Some of these worlds might even mimic Earth during the early Carboniferous period, around 359 million years ago, when our planet boasted a climate akin to a tropical rainforest. Gliese 667cc serves as a perfect example. This exoplanet, the next closest deemed superhabitable, orbits a red dwarf within the Gliese 667 triple star system. Yes, a system with 3 stars. From the surface of Gliese 667cc, the daytime sky would dazzle with the light from these 3 suns. Located 23.62 light years from Earth, Gliese 667cc has at least 3.7 times the mass of Earth. Another intriguing candidate is Kepler 452b, sometimes dubbed Earth 2.0. This planet orbits a G-type star, much like our Sun, but 1.5 billion years older and slightly larger. There's speculative chatter about an ancient civilization that might have once flourished either on Kepler 452b or a moon orbiting it, hinting at what might be the distant future for Earth. This speculation arises because the star it orbits is nearing the end of its life cycle, expanding into a red giant. Despite these fascinating discoveries, a major hurdle remains: detecting oxygen in the atmospheres of these exoplanets. But change is on the horizon. On October 31st, 2021, the James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, is set to launch aboard an Ariane 5 rocket. This successor to the Hubble Space Telescope will station itself 940,000 miles from Earth, beyond the Moon's orbit, and will undertake a revolutionary role in studying distant celestial bodies. With cutting-edge technology, the JWST aims to detect the unique signal that oxygen molecules emit when they collide, a potential indicator of life. The JWST will probe the history of the universe, including distant exoplanets, other galaxies, and the cosmic microwave background, providing insights into the Big Bang and the evolution of our solar system. Yet, to explore even further, the Nancy Grace Roman Telescope, slated for a launch in the late 2020s, we'll extend our gaze deeper into space with a viewing field 100 times greater than Hubble's. This telescope will delve into the mysteries of dark matter and dark energy, potentially imaging exoplanets directly, an ability currently beyond Earth-based technologies. This new era of advanced telescopes will enhance our understanding of the cosmos, potentially revealing thousands more exoplanets through techniques like gravitational microlensing. As we edge closer to these groundbreaking launches, we stand on the brink of possibly discovering life on distant worlds, ushering in a thrilling chapter in the story of human exploration and our quest to understand the universe's vast and varied nature. Love all things cosmic? Be sure to check out our Cosmoglow store and bring the wonders of the galaxy to your bedroom.